this pyramid once before, Guardian. Ikora believes there is more to be found.
How will communing with darkness help us understand the voices we heard when we found Sagira's shell?
Reach the statue at the heart of the pyramid. Strengthen your connection to the darkness, and you will see beyond the limitations of normal sight.
Interesting. I'm picking up a Cabal transmission. I pulled a clip for you.
To the warriors of the Cabal Empire, defectors march upon the European Pyramid, searching for trinkets of darkness. Their expedition is not sanctioned. Any that join them act alone. My father's obsession with the voice in the darkness must not infect our own ranks.
I guess this means the Empress won't mind us fighting our way in.
Thank you.
Cabal shield blocking the doorway. Looks like they got up here first. The pyramid is reacting to our presence somehow. Opening doors, moving platforms.
Perhaps it senses something in you. When I explored these strange passageways, I felt it sensed something in me, too. I resented it at first. To believe it recognized in me some secret kinship. But like you, Guardian, I have learned to use it.
Supplies everywhere. It looks like they're trying to establish a foothold inside the pyramid.
Hoping to pilfer artifacts of darkness for their war against war itself, I assume. Zivu Arath destroyed their homeworld, and the conquerors do not take well to being conquered.
I think that device is jamming the pyramid's movement somehow. You said the pyramid recognizes something in us, Eris. But what?
A defender. A finely honed blade. Curiosity. It could be any of those. Or none. My Cora too has asked this question, and my answer is always the same. Pure speculation. I worry the ambiguity weighs on her too heavily.
Thank you.
I don't think the pyramid is helping us out of generosity, Guardian. It's manipulating us, using us somehow. The darkness is a neutral force, but the pyramids have an agenda. Until we know what it is, we can't let our guard down. Something must control these ships. We've never seen a pilot.
In her journeys beyond the Heliopause, Queen Marasov encountered the entity that commands the pyramids. She said its mind spoke louder than any other she has ever heard. A cacophony of thought. Perhaps those voices steer these ships. One of those voices spoke to you in the Black Garden as well.
Let's go.
Ikora said that this new ability allows you to see psychic imprints of past events. And if you commune with the pyramid, you might be able to see the imprint on Sagira's shell. It's strange. The light made you forget, and now the darkness helps you remember. The Cabal are trying to destroy the statue. We have to stop them, or you won't be able to commune with the pyramid. Cabal are trying to destroy the statue. We have to stop them, or you won't be able to commune with the pyramid. Eris, we communed with the statue. We can't tell yet if anything has changed. It seems like we might not notice the effects until we're back in Sabathun's throne world. Either way, we don't want to stay here longer than we have to.
Wise, these ships are still a mystery to us.
I admit, even after I sent you off, I had my doubts. But Eris reports the pyramid responded to your presence. A sign that we're headed in the right direction, I think. Now that you've paid a visit to the pyramid, you should be able to reveal the memory on Sagara's shell in full. The fact you can't means there's still something we're missing. The Hidden have been analyzing the wounds you see all across the desert. The areas around them emanate with strong concentrations of psychic energy. They've located a similar concentration inside the throne world. I believe that's what we need in order to make Savathun's memory fully manifest. Take Sagira's shell there. Then we'll see if I'm correct. Hopefully, this is how we'll finally find some answers. Carry the light.
Thank you. my hip. As you know, our inquiry into Mars has grown well beyond its original bounds. As of right now, it seems the relic is our common link between the phenomena here and Savathun's plans. I want to know how, and I want to know why. Continue your assignments. Evidence, leads, anything of relevance, be sure to log it here.
Put some of these, you know, pieces together. We're gonna have to work together.
Guardian, the psychic energy my hidden detected is concentrated in this area. Find the source, and you might be able to learn more from Sagira's chef. It's possible she learned how Savathun stole the Traveler's life before she died. There must be some clue here. Search the area. I've delivered the general location data to your ghost, though I don't have anything precise.
I'm sensing pyramid-related interference between us and the coordinates Ikora sent. There must be a way to get around it. Destroy it. That helped, but I'm picking up another source of interference. Let's track it down. Ikora, we encountered pyramid interference. The one on Europa was so welcoming to us. What changed?
On Europa, I suspect that your purposes overlap neatly with the pyramids. You destroyed the Cabal. It granted you more power. Here, your presence hardly registers. You have nothing to ask for and nothing to offer. Remember, the pyramid entity considers itself neither our friend nor our enemy.
These old, half-forgotten pathways. That power you're using is making them real again. Rebuilding them through memory.
Hopefully, Sagira's shell holds that same potential. With the right concentration of psychic energy, a resonant memory connected to her shell will manifest. But this is all theoretical still. It's never been done.
Once we learned Sabathun was impersonating Osiris, I wanted to believe Sagira was still alive, trapped somewhere, like him. That if we played our cards right, we'd free her too. But at least we found her. She can help us one last time, and then we can bring her home.
Thank you.
Cora. I think we found it. There's something here.
Find a connection point. We need answers now.
Distorted symbols. I can't quite make them out. Let's look at this from another angle. We might be able to see the symbols better from higher up. What is this place? Ikora, we've been transported somewhere. It doesn't look like the rest of Sabathun's throne world. Ikora? We lost her, Guardian. I guess we're going in alone.
Stand before a being with a thousand names. It whispers one. The witness. Remember it. Remember that name. It is not darkness, but something that wears it like a cloak. It gives darkness a wicked shape. I refuse to be its servant. I spent centuries crafting schemes, playing tricks, finding loopholes. And then I select my new name. A man with many enemies and few friends. But those friends know secrets about the light. About new beginnings. My plan takes shape.
That came from Sagira's shell. Like a psychic imprint. A memory. Sabathun's memory. And if that's what it was, it means she used Ikora's relationship with Osiris to learn something about the light. Something dangerous.
Whoa, you saw a what? A memory? See, I knew Sagira's shell would start us in the right direction. I knew it! Okay, here's the tip. Ever heard of Oryx? The Taken King? Sabathun's brother? Yeah. Okay, I thought so. Sabathun's got a temple dedicated to him. Look, I know what you're thinking. Who cares, right? But we found Sagira's shell in a temple dedicated to the sister Zivu. Imagine what we could find in Oryx's temple. Okay, as far as how we get in, well, you just leave that to me.